Hello, Delight Channel. Last week we started talking about something. Were you here? If you were not, better go and watch. We are talking of some very fundamental things that we believe will really add a lot of value to you. So last week we started talking about customer management. And the only thing we dwelt on last week has to do with keeping your eye on the value offering. Okay? Very, very fundamental. Without any further ado, we'd like to go on to the next one so that we see how quickly we can get this over with. And that has to do with the relationship. In dealing with your customer, it should not just be about transaction. You need to be deliberate to build a relationship. When you build relationships, when there are service issues, instead of the customer complaining to competition, the relationship will make them come back to tell you yourself. When there are service issues, the relationship will make them want to give you a second chance and a third chance, as long as you are displaying enough good faith to solve those problems. So, when we speak about customer management, we are saying, let it not just be about the transaction. Be deliberate to build relationships. How do you do that? You need to try and worry about how you can implement account management in your organization. Depending on the type of business that you are doing, you need to find a system that works for you. If you are a B2C, you will realize that it may not be very straightforward to do that, but at least if you have high net worth individuals that do business with you, you need to be deliberate to look after them. But if you are a B2B, okay, or you are a B2G, or you deal with corporate institutions, it is necessary that even if you are not able to implement a key account management for all your customers, you need to apply the Pareto principle. You know what that means? Which says that 80% of your value will come from approximately 20% of your customers or 20% of your effort. Identify those critical 20% and be deliberate to build a relationship with them. And it doesn't come too expensive. Once you are deliberate and you are interested in finding out how, simple things like just appointing account managers that may never need to do anything, as long, particularly if your processes are efficient and your products are very reliable and credible. But the fact that you have appointed somebody to look after those customers make them feel really looked after. And in the few times when they have issues, if those setup, if those people you have appointed into that setup are able to resolve the problem, it even makes it more exciting. So, be deliberate to build relationship. Relationship means that you are interested in them beyond just the transactions. You are not just trying to make money from them. You are looking at how can you really help them to solve problems. You are identifying areas where they are struggling, you are noting their pain point, and you are trying to accommodate that in your design and in your delivery within your own profitable framework to ensure that they are delighted. So, be deliberate to build relationship. And in building relationship, I want to move to point number three, which has to do with the emotional part of the interaction. Believe me, human beings, we don't do things because of reasons. We do things because of feelings, and we find reasons for them. We are largely, predominantly emotional animals. And therefore, you need to be deliberate to locate the emotional points of your customers, whether they are institutions or they are individuals. Deliberately locate their emotional points. What do I mean by that? Some people, they are very private. They do not want any publicity about what they are doing, particularly as individuals. If you go and place a newspaper advert for such people when they are having any ceremony, you will realize that you may be upsetting them rather than making them feel comfortable. All they need may just be an SMS, a private email, a courtesy visit. And if your customer is a loud one who wants everybody to know something is going on, and then you send a line or a mail or a message, you probably are just on your own. You are not tickling that point. You are not hitting that nerve. You need to locate the emotional point. And many times it's very cheap. You know, showing up in their events, corporate, individual, sharing in their struggles as organizations, as individual. I mean, you hear that your company, your customer, maybe there was fire and they lost their records and they couldn't do anything and so they couldn't place orders, and you've got credibility with them, but you are insisting they need to place and follow the process before you can serve them. You are not helping them. You are not trying to have that emotional connection with them. So you need to locate the emotional points. From simple things like birthdays, simple things like ceremonial greetings, simple things like anniversary, simple things like showing up at their events and their occasion. Whatever it is that you need to do, be deliberate about it. Build relationships, find out what their emotional points are, and continue to massage it and tickle it, because these are the things that keep them glued to you. And I want to end with this story that I read somewhere. There was this young boy that went into a store somewhere in America, I believe, and then he requested to use the phone. And then he called a number and picked up the phone, called the number, and the lady on the other line had a conversation with him. And the boy said, "Please, I'd like to be given the opportunity to mow your lawn." And the lady said, "No, I'm fine. I got somebody doing that for me." And the young boy said, "You know what? I'll do it very good. I promise I will give you exceptional service." The young lady said, "No, I am happy with the person that is currently doing the service." The boy said, "You know what? I'm even ready to do it at a discount." The lady on the other side still insisted, "I'm sorry, but I'm very satisfied with the young man doing it right now. I'm not trying to change him." The young boy said, "Okay, thank you, my lady," dropped the phone and turned to leave. And then the store owner turned and said, "Hey, young man, come here. I'm interested in helping you. I'd like to offer you the job to mow my lawn." The young boy looked at him and said, "No, I actually wasn't looking for a job. I was just checking with the lady to see how I am doing. The person currently mowing her lawn is actually me. I'm trying to find out whether my service is satisfactory or not." That is what happens when you keep your eye on your customer. You are interested in relationship, and it is not just a transaction. When you know how to hit the emotional point, you are going to build loyalty, you are going to build commitment, and you can be sure that it will take more than just a careless offering to get your customer off your books. I got to stop here again this week. I got two more points to cover, and I hope to do that briskly next week, and you sure do not want to miss it. So I request you to please share this as widely as you can. Show us some love. Let's know exactly how this is hitting you, and let us know what we can do, as we have just been saying, to make you more loyal, more committed, and enjoy our services better. And until I come your way again next week, don't ever forget, T-Mark is still my name, and all I'm trying to do is what? Make a little difference. Always a pleasure to have you here, and I'll see you next week. Bye.